Welcome to the video tutorial on the pharmacology of Parkinson's disease. Parkinson's disease is the second most common neurodegenerative disease after Alzheimer's disease and affects 1% of all people over 60 and 4% of all those over 80. When examining the pharmacological treatment of Parkinson's disease, there are four main drugs and drug classes we will be concerned with. Levodopa, dopamine agonists, monoamine oxidase B inhibitors, also known as MAOB inhibitors, and catechol-O-methyltransferase, or COMT inhibitors, but more on that shortly. Let's start off by introducing a simple representation of the anatomy and physiology relevant to Parkinson's disease. Here we have a representation of the blood-brain barrier, a nigrostriatal dopaminergic neuron, which produces the neurotransmitter dopamine, and a neuron in the corpus striatum, which upon activation by dopamine, exerts its modulating effect on movement pathways, leading to smoother, more coordinated movement. There are also some very important enzymes at work in these regions. Dopa-decarboxylase, which is present both peripherally outside the blood-brain barrier, and centrally within nigrostriatal dopaminergic neurons. MAOB, which is present in nigrostriatal neurons. And COMT, which is present centrally and peripherally. It is important to note that there are dopamine receptors present on neurons within the corpus striatum. In Parkinson's disease, nigrostriatal dopaminergic neurons are not able to produce enough dopamine, which stops the neurons in the corpus striatum from exerting their control on movement pathways, leading to the characteristic tremor and jerky movements associated with Parkinson's disease. One way to counteract this is to give the patient levodopa, the precursor to dopamine. Let's see what happens if we administer levodopa. As it will be given in tablet or capsule form, levodopa enters the systemic circulation outside the blood-brain barrier. Therefore, a certain amount will be metabolized by the enzyme dopa-decarboxylase to dopamine. However, this dopamine outside the blood-brain barrier will give rise to peripheral side effects, such as nausea, movement disorders such as tics, also known as dyskinesias, and joint stiffness. Some levodopa will be metabolized by peripheral COMT to 3-O-methyldopa, or 3-OMD, which further reduces the amount of peripheral levodopa available to cross the blood-brain barrier. In the end, only 5-10% of administered levodopa actually manages to cross the blood-brain barrier. It is then taken up into nigrostriatal dopaminergic neurons, where it is metabolized by dopa-decarboxylase into dopamine. Some of this dopamine will be metabolized by MAOB into 3,4-dihydroxylphenylacetic acid, or DOPAC for short, and some will be metabolized by central COMT to 3-methoxytyramine. The end result is less dopamine available to be transported to the dopamine receptor on neurons in the corpus striatum. From this you can see that both peripheral and central enzymes greatly reduce the efficacy of levodopa therapy. However, there are ways we can get around this. Carbidopa and benzeracide are dopa-decarboxylase inhibitors. They block the actions of peripheral dopa-decarboxylase, stopping it from breaking down levodopa into dopamine. This reduces the side effects of levodopa treatment, as well as making more levodopa available to cross the blood-brain barrier. COMT inhibitors, such as entacapone, block peripheral COMT. Blocking the actions of these two peripheral enzymes results in more levodopa crossing the blood-brain barrier to be taken up by nigrostriatal dopaminergic neurons, where it is metabolized by centrally acting dopa-decarboxylase to produce dopamine. To prevent this dopamine being broken down by MAOB, an MAOB inhibitor such as selegiline can be used. and to prevent dopamine being broken down by centrally acting COMT, a COMT inhibitor such as tolcapone can be administered. The overall effect of these medications is to increase the amount of dopamine available to be transported to the dopamine receptors on the neurons in the corpus striatum, increasing its influence on movement pathways and reducing the movement problems associated with Parkinson's disease. In addition to these drug treatments, dopamine agonists such as bromocriptine and pergolide can also be very beneficial. These act directly on the dopamine receptors of the neurons in the corpus striatum, stimulating the modulating effect it has on movement pathways and reducing the characteristic tremor and other movement disorders associated with Parkinson's disease.